My name is Roxana Dronca. I am the chair of the Hematology Oncology Division at Mayo Clinic, Florida. I am a medical oncologist and I treat advanced skin cancers and advanced genitourinary malignancies. At Mayo Clinic, we have extensive clinical as well as research expertise in the care of patients with complex advanced skin cancers such as melanoma, cutaneous cell cancer or bladder cancer, kidney cancer, testicular or prostate cancer. We have multidisciplinary integrated expertise. We see the patients and make a coordinated management decision, and our physicians participate in clinical trials and research that offers their patients access to novel drugs and cutting-edge therapies. At Mayo Clinic, we have a number of novel technologies in the treatment of patients with advanced genitourinary malignancies. For instance, Mayo Clinic has recently opened the cyclotron building. This will allow us to produce on-site radioisotopes with a short half-life that can be used for the more precise molecular diagnosis, as well as in the future for the personalized and individualized treatment of certain malignancies. The cyclotron is very beneficial in the diagnosis of prostate cancers before they become evident by conventional images. With PET choline, we are able to diagnose prostate cancer recurrence at much lower levels of PSA. I believe that in the future, we will be able to utilize radioisotopes for the more precise molecular diagnosis of other malignancies and also for the targeted radiotherapeutic treatment of advanced cancers. My research interest is in the area of tumor immunology and cancer immunotherapy. Currently, I am involved in the study of anti-PD-1 drugs, both to understand the mechanism of action as well as the mechanism of resistance to this treatment, what makes some patients respond and some patients actually become resistant to therapy. We are working in developing novel combinations to rescue patients who become resistant to anti-PD-1 therapy, such as combinations of chemo, immunotherapy, or combinations involving immunotherapy and oncolytic viruses. We also have a very active biomarker program where we are studying biomarkers that can help us predict who is going to respond to immunotherapy, patients who will benefit from these novel agents, or patients who will develop toxicities to this treatment. In recent years, there have been significant advances in the treatment of these complex malignancies, both in targeted therapy, immunotherapy agents, as well as novel radiopharmaceuticals. I believe that in the future, there's going to be a significant progress in the combination as well as the sequencing of these agents to obtain the most benefit and the longest survival for the patients. The future is bright. I think we are going to see more cures in advanced cancers, including melanoma, kidney cancer, bladder cancer. I think we're going to see many patients live a lot longer life and with good quality of life. I believe that cancer will become a chronic disease and in some instances a curable disease.